The other day I came across an article about the lost subway tunnels of Los Angeles, not from the new subways that they're building, but from the old days when the Pacific Electric red cars were plying the streets of LA County. And I knew about a couple of them, but there was one that I'd never heard of. And this article actually gave the addresses for the buildings that are on top of or right in front of the old exits. It also said that the Bonaventure Hotel cut right through, the foundations cut through the tunnel. So that was enough information for me to go on Google Maps and plot the both entrances in the sort of south and the north, and then draw a line and see where that tunnel was. It just made me realize that if you were at any of the places along that line in LA, you could kind of look down metaphorically and realize that there was space underneath you, there was infrastructure. A buddy of mine here in the office, Rob Capp, saw what I was doing, and he said that he knew about the same kind of thing in San Francisco. He knew of one entrance to a tunnel, he didn't know what it was. We did a little bit of Googling around, we figured out it was part of an old train line that serviced Fisherman's Wharf, used Google Street View to find the other entrance, and drew another line right under Fort Mason Park. If you're in the community garden and you dig down too deep, you plant the wrong root vegetable, I suppose, you end up in a tunnel. So that made me start thinking about underground cities in general, because I know that there are huge cultures of urban spelunking in places like Paris with its catacombs, or New York and forgotten sewer and subway tunnels. And there's something romantic about that. I know that in the history of humanity, there's plenty of stories about the underworld, but to me, there's something really elegant about the idea of building our own underworlds, these places that exist, that we create, but that happened so long ago that we forget about them, and then remember them again later. That's happened in Chicago. It's happened in Las Vegas, where people live in the water, the tunnels that are there to get the desert rain out of the city before everybody floods out. All of which put me in mind of a story. The scariest thing that ever happened to me in a city, which I suppose I'm lucky because this isn't super scary, but when I was first living in New York, mid-90s sometime, I was crossing Houston at about 1st Street or Avenue A, somewhere in the East Village, middle of the night, headed to a bar, I suppose. And I looked to my left when I was on the center median and saw a shape coming toward me and realized that it was a person. I couldn't tell if it was a man or a woman. The person was wearing some kind of big cloak, backlit by the oncoming traffic. And I sort of stopped, paralyzed, because I didn't know what this person was doing, and they were on the center median on Houston. And then that person stopped, bent over, and lifted up what I realized was a grate or a manhole cover, something that led underground, and then paused, and then disappeared into it, just dropped right into the ground, and the grate closed behind him or her. And I found that terrifying, but also exciting, because what it taught me in that moment, before I'd ever read anything about this in New York, was that there was a whole city under my city. That there was an infrastructure down there that I didn't know about, that I was never going to see. And I found that weirdly comforting, to know that there were pieces of this thing that humanity had created, this city all around me, that were mysterious, that were hidden. All of which is not to say that all of us should be going out and trying to find those places, because potentially I suppose that's dangerous or not right, but I will say that I'm glad they're there, and watch your step.